Now, Vice President Sara Duterte, what are her midterm plans? She said she'll run in the next elections. That would be 2025. She's a sitting vice president right now. Have you spoken to her?
Not yet, Karen, about that issue. Hindi pa kami nag-usap. Usapan tungkol dyan.
Okay, but would you want, what would you advise the vice president? Should she, because there are different talks that are circulating. She might run for the Senate. There are even talks she might run for Quezon City Mayor. I mean, it's really going from left to right to left field, right? So, anong narinig po ninyo?
Wala pa kong narinig. No? Basta ako, whatever her wishes are, I'm here to support her.
Oo.
Ganyan okay. Ka supportive sa ating Vice President. Kung ano man gusto niya, andito lang ako sa likuran mo, ma'am, at sumusuporta sa iyo.
Now, are you running for re-election yourself?
Yes, Karen, yes.
Okay, right, yeah, okay, fine. Now, moving forward, moving on to a bigger political question here. When I interviewed Representative Alvarez, he says he's now in good terms with former President Duterte, and to a degree, even with Vice President Sara Duterte, he said even if they were in opposite sides during the last elections, is he'd rather support her because she's a Mindanaoan. Is it right to say na mas solid ngayon kayong mga Duterte allies? You, the former president, Sara, and now former Speaker Pantaleon Alvarez. Are you all now united more than ever?
Natural tendency yan, Karen. Eh. Pag nakita mo yung isang kapwa mo Mindanaoan, binubugbog, ay talaga mag-consolidate yan lahat at magsusuporta. Mag-guan yan, mag-consolidate yan ng forces. Dahil kinakawawa nyo kami, sige nga, we will fight. Madali lang magkaisa yung mga taga Mindanao ka rin. Dahil for a very long time, matagal na kami neglected doon sa Mindanao. Madali lang kami magkakaisa. Dahil matagal ng panahon na neglected ang Mindanao pagdating sa development.
Okay. All right. And what are you seeing in the future? Is this another Marcos Romualdez Duterte face-off?
Well, too early to tell. Kasi no, marami pa pwedeng mangyayari yan along the way. So let's just observe. Kung yan ang nakita mo ngayon na magiging contending parties, contending groups towards the end, posible yan, pero as I've said, marami pang pwede mangyayari. Yung isang issue dyan, yung sinabi mo pa na his VP Inday Sara is planning to run this midterm election. Hindi pa alam kung as a senator or as a mayor of Davao, hindi pa natin alam. So maraming mangyayari along the way.
All right. Okay. Well, on that note, I want to thank you so much for being with me today, as always. Thank you so much, Senator Ronald Bato de la Rosa. Thank you.
Thank you, Karen. Maraming salamat.
As always.